Greg, I think the last time we did scissor speed and butterfly speed. So we're going to work on when the arm can cross. So the one here with this, again, have our traditional pretty much college lead us our style.
Okay, so when I can get the arm grab coming across, that's when we're ready to move. So we covered if you have the wizard, we can do our triangles and stuff like that. There's a bunch of other ones to do there. And we also have our wrist control sitting up with our humor guillotine kind of a series. And then it has the high arm. We had our scissors feet, something like that, put the lens up again. Hook sweep or butterfly sweep. Okay, so if I have the wrist control, well, we have a move from there. If you have a wizard, we have some moves from there. If you get the arm a little higher, we have some moves from here. And then if the arm comes across with an arm drag. Okay, so here, pull the arm across. There's an arm drag. So that's going to be today's. Okay, so when I get the arm drag here, boom, I'm going to slide the arm across. Basically, on the theoretical level, whenever your arm crosses the middle line, the top guy, you're in trouble. Okay, it's much better for the bottom guy if I can cross the elbow along this measuring line of the middle. So once I get here like this, boom, I slide the arm across here. I'm going to try to stiff arm the hand out. Okay, now from him, he just wants to get the elbow back to the other side. Okay, so I need to close the gap here. So once I slide the arm across here, I want to try to put my body behind the tricep, and then I'm going to try to kind of climb the back a little bit here. So once I arm drag here, I'm going to sit up and grab. Are you trying to grab around the armpit here? Okay, I'm not really worried about grips at first. I'm going to sit up and I cover. Basically, I'm going to put my stomach behind the tricep here and kind of hug his head. I'm trying to keep my head above his head. Kind of the rule of all scrambles. Whoever's head's on top tends to win the scramble battle. Okay, so once I get here, I put toward the top. We're going to work on two different grips to begin with. I'm trying to fit his hand to my hand that's kind of hugging the top here. So the first one here is I can grab under the armpit. So I shove it through and I grab the arm underneath. You can grab the wrist itself or you can grab like the cuff grip. Okay, if you want to get IBJJ legal, you can't see your fingers inside here. But you can get this grip here, pistol grip. However you want to do that. If you're going to enter IBJJ tournaments, we'll make a bigger deal of that later. Okay, but here, I'm going to control the arm here. I feel this is one of the better grips because when you're trying to defend the hooks, his elbow can't pin next to his hip bone. Okay, so that's why this one's probably higher percentage. Okay, so once I get my grip set up here with my arm drag and I grab under the armpit, our formula for taking the back is always going to be elbow, knee, hook. Okay, so when you're doing a back take, elbow, knee, hook. Okay, I'm going to get above the elbow so that I can get up on my knee. I keep the hook in between the legs, it'll take it all the way out, and it's going to buy me the space to put my hook. All right. When I first started doing arm drags, I just thought it was put the hook inside, so I always try to put the hook, and then I can almost sort of get it going on, and then the guy puts a leg up here, and then he starts pushing into me, and then eventually he starts clearing it everything out, and then you kind of feel like you almost get the hook, and I have a little bit longer leg, so that's why it kind of affected me more with this, and I feel like I almost get the hook inside. So for me to get my hook inside here, I need to get on my knee, and the only way I can get on my knee is if I get on my elbow. So if I'm flat on your shoulder here, this part here is very hard to get on your knee. It's not as easy to do unless you're on your elbow. So once I get on here, I'll get on my elbow first. That's gonna allow me to get off my hip so I can slide my knee in between his legs and keep my one hook in already. And then I'll have a space to get my hook. Okay, once we get our hook here, I like you guys to sprawl. I always try to sprawl someone out so they get their knees off the ground. And then you really dominate the position. If they're kind of curled up like this and you're kind of too high, I see it happen sometimes. Sometimes they'll grab your head and then they'll pull it back in. And then they kind of pull themselves back underneath, so be careful of that. So here, well, I'll come across here. I'll grab the wrist of the other hand here. Once I get my arm drag and I secure my grip, it's gonna be elbow, knee, hook. Okay? I always try to sprawl the guys out. And I always try to get his knees off the ground. Once you get the knees off the ground, it really sucks to the guy in the bottom. Right?
Alright. So there's an arm drag and grabbing on the armpit foot. Everybody got it? Any questions? Alright, try it out. 1, 2, 3.
Can you try to fall down? Yes, sir. Hands up. I'm not going to lose that stuff.
Pistol grip because I can push and I can still have control here. Okay, so sometimes when I'm doing the arm, I can't, since I'm not controlling the forearm here, when I'm coming this way like this, I'm not really controlling his arm, so if he's really had a defensive posture, he can put the elbow by his hip and like make a defensive posture here. So I can never grab on the armpit. I can't fit this hand under the armpit if you have a defensive posture here. Okay, and since I'm not touching the arm, I can't move it or anything like that. So once I see the hand lower, or when I sit up here and I try to get here and I feel that it's tight, I'm just not gonna go under anymore. Okay, I just go over the arm and then I'm gonna grab with the gift wrap. Okay, just the gift wrap. So let's get the gift wrap here. Okay, the main thing on the gift wrap here is my free arm here, I wanna keep on the front of the elbow. Okay, so when I sit up for my elbow knee hook, I'm blocking the elbow down because I don't want his elbow to come in front of the face to help unravel my grip wrap. So once I push it across here, I'm here like this. A lot of times my free hand here, I'll just post up on his elbow here and then I'm on my elbow as well. So that's part of my move. I got my elbow. I'm gonna slide my foot out, knee. Okay, now here, he can have the block going in here early. Okay, but since I'm already on elbow and knee, then I can like step my foot right on top of the elbow. Okay, and as I just stomp my foot through the elbow, it's very hard for him to, you know, push your elbow up when someone's stepping on it. So I'm here like this. I just use my weight. I just put my foot right in there. And I just come up high, pushing it in until it gets all up to the ground. And then I'm going to start coming up. I try to hold the gift wrap here so that I can get my hand in on this side. I'm just putting my hand up because he's losing his balance. But I'll slide my hand here and like I'll go for a double attack or roller coaster ride, either with two hands here or the double attack. Either one will work fine. I just need my hand on the underhook here so that I can help push myself back if I have to. So I can slide up here. Alright. And then I still got the knees up here. Fine. I got the arms controlled. You can start setting up your choke if you wanted to. But the control is much more important than the rear naked choke. What a lot of people do is they'll rush the choke. And if you totally forget your hooks, you're gonna get rolled often. So get the position first, like our whole theory, position before submission, get the good hooks, sprawl him out, and then go for a choke. Here, okay, we're gonna get our arm drag here. I start coming out to the side, but I see that the armpit is a little bit tight on the side, so I just lift it up in the ground. Okay, once I get my grip here, hand on the elbow, so that I can slide my foot all the way out. Remember, you should keep your knee inside. If I take my foot all the way out to the side here, then we're in a side turtle, and then I gotta start going for an aisle ride or something like that. But I have my foot hooked in here. I'm gonna step my foot all the way through.
boom, and then I can sprawl them out. Try to keep the arm pinned. Okay, when I get here and I have the roller coaster ride or double tack, I keep the hand pinned on the arm so he can't move it anymore. Then the same side arm is very hard for him to stop me from sliding across. Okay, it's always the cross arm. So see how this hand's free? If this keeps up, if this hand's coming through, this hand can grab my hand. It's much easier defense because it's the opposite arm. But this hand has a very hard time from stopping me from coming across. Okay? So let me see this hand here. I just dive it in between. Boom. You can come all the way across. Come up. You're gonna grab all the way up, slide it over. Okay. Try to always want to sprawl them out. See that elbow's a little bit in front here? I can just push it forward. Now it's like on top of him. Then his hand's stuck. As long as I sprawl here, try to move the hand. It's super tough. Okay? But if it's in front, then his hand can like try to grab. And it gets to like a little flag, and then he can grab my hand. Okay, but when I got my roller coaster right here, boom, I slide it down. I sprawl on top of his hand and everything. And then the same side hand has a hard time stopping this grip from sliding through. It sucks up.
Yeah.
Basically, just like surfing on top of your elbow on your sternum. But it sucks. But a lot of people think if you're on, they don't like do the knees part. So if you're not on your knees, it's a really different position. So if I'm here like this, and he's up in a full turtle like this, then his arms can be in place and I'm kind of moving around. And if I slide really high, then I'm going off of it, and it's going to be like a harder position. Okay, so try to keep your hips lower, and I have my position. I like to sprawl up forward. You can't do the Superman, but the Superman, I'm going to be higher. So the Superman's like, I use both our hips here, and I just like, you fly, and then the guy gets broken down. It sucks, huh?
Yeah.
That's crazy. See Mike Lowe right there. That's Mike Lowe from Superman. So, always try to break the guy down. If he's in a turtle on his elbows and knees, he still has a better position. Once you break him down off his knees and his elbows, he's pretty much dead meat. All right, so let's try it out. One, two, three. Right here. One.
Okay. I try to kind of fit the hand that I'm pinning the arm.
Okay, so if you start getting better guys, they're gonna know like now I'm getting hooked, right? But if he can just hold my foot up, people will do that. So they'll tend to put this leg up here and then they'll pinch the elbow on my foot on this side so you guys can see. Okay, so once I know the elbow and the hook part, I'll grab any grip I can here. So then I'll get up here, but now I can't put my knee on the ground. Okay, so I got my arm drag here, I set my grip up, but then he's gonna stop part of my formula. My formula is elbow, knee, hook. But if I can't put my knee on the ground, my foot was never gonna really hook inside. And I have decently long legs. Okay, so once I see this, they're kind of stopping my move, and they're hoping that I kind of give up, or like I'll hold this part not so good, and then they'll start shrinking the elbow up, elbow up, elbow up, and then they square me off again, and then I've lost my advantage from the arm drag. Okay, this will happen when you start throwing somebody gets up 3-4 times, you're like, oh, you guys don't want to get something more. Okay, so here, boom, arm across, I hold, and then I'm gonna start trying to hold my leg up. Okay, this happens after a few times doing the back muscle. Okay, so once I see this hand and posture coming here, okay, my hand's gonna start sliding through, okay, to the leg. Well, they call it the flower seat, or almost like our pendulum seat that we did from the hooking the leg. Just here, and then I slide in. Okay, so just like how we do with the hook leg. He's gonna be here. He's gonna make sure my knee goes up and down, trying to get my elbow knee hook. Doesn't work. I'm gonna slide through. Okay, I'm still holding the hand and trying to pinch this part to my chest. And then everything we did worked out with our pendulum sleep. I want to try to sweep them over this shoulder, like where my head started off originally. This way. You want to slide your foot inside so it doesn't get rolled over. And then we can come to the top. Okay, so Continuing on with our motion, even though like our primary move, move A, is being blocked, we're going to move B. So either arm drag back fake or arm drag flower fake or pinch, whatever you want to call it. Hey, we got it. We did it before, so it should be easy. Pick track. One, two, three.
I just do this one because I don't know. It's just like I feel it happens for me a lot, so cover this. So when I get my arm drag here. I'm gonna get the grip like so, but maybe I can't grab this hand over with the gift wrap or the underhook. So I just have like the back. Okay, the arm free grab. So I don't want to get a better grip here. Okay. And then from here, a lot of times we're gonna kind of keep pushing into me this way to help eventually clear the shoulder out. Like they're trying to push in, push in, push in to keep trying to slide off. Okay, so when happens live. So like I'll get arm drag here, and if they do nothing here, pretty much like you're gonna be able to do one of the other ones. Okay, like I'm not trying to escape. You know how we practice really statically, the other ones feel great. But when you start going live, the guy knows I gotta get my shoulder up and my elbow across. They kind of keep pulling their way to help square off. They're not gonna stay except the arm drag. They're gonna keep pulling the arm back. Just have to grab and get in a bear hug and then restart their whole passing. Yeah, okay, so when I feel them like pushing into me, this move works great. Okay, so
once I get the arm right here, when I reach over and grab, I try to grab the lat or I just grab whatever I can. Sometimes the belt, whatever. Any grip on the side here that helps hug is gonna work. Okay? So when I feel him pushing into me here, I'm gonna slide back a little bit as well, like little small shrimps. Okay, and then my up free leg on the back side here is gonna slide in. I'm gonna put like a butterfly hook in. Okay, so I'm gonna slide, I'm gonna do a shrimp out here, and then I'm gonna put my butterfly hook in. Okay, and then from here, when I keep pulling into me, pushing into me, I'm gonna do like a reverse butterfly sweep. Hold it on my leg here. Okay, so the trick here is loading them onto your butterfly legs. Okay, so I slide here, he starts pushing into me, I make a little bit more space than he does, and I have my foot inside here, so when I'm trying to load them, my shoulders will be like a little bit lower, it's going to be a lot much higher, and then I'm just going to frame my body together, which any grip you're going to get here. Then when I put both my shoulders flat on the ground, he's gonna be loaded on my leg. Okay? It's not fall back and pull. That doesn't really work. Okay? I just frame so that when I, as I fall back, everything's being pulled on top of me. And then I'm kicking him on the second half.
Alright? It's never very small like that, ever. Okay?
So I'll take the arms right here and try to square. Just a little push.
And then I go. Okay, so a lot of the guy's pushing into you because he's trying to square off, square off, square off. And then as I get my hook in, the next time I push into you, I load and throw. I do reverse butterfly. Alright, everyone, see it one time. Slow motion. I get the arm right here. I feel them. I'm going to square up, square up. I put my hook in, okay? Then I fall back. This is loaded. So the hand grip, I'm pushing that hand across. If I don't have a hand grip, I'm palming the elbow to help push. Okay, and then the second part of the pitch. I think I want to take this. I'll come up here. Okay. If he's a jiu-jitsu guy, they kind of stay flat for you. If they wrestle it at all, they'll spin over. It's very hard to control that part. I don't think you can have it accurate to predict that. It's probably a reaction to the air. It's going to be one of those things. Either flat or like a turtle. That's more turtle than the aisle ride back. Everybody got it? It's a little bit more complicated. You got to get the load and then follow through. The load is probably the hardest part. Okay, let's try it out. One, two, three. Oh.
this guy, this is the GPU guy. So it's the same guy.
Hook the leg. Yeah, when you feel you can't really pendulum, do the butt scoop. Yeah. I want to repeat, yeah. Thank you. All right, guys, time.